Hi guys, welcome to my new video. You might have noticed that I have not been posting new videos recently. Reason being that I have been busy going out for physical viewings. There have been more requests to view the house physically after the circuit breaker. But I would like to thank you this customer who reminded me, which really motivated me to carry on to do these videos, and I managed to did it. So I hope I can help to give everyone a better understanding how is our property market is. So please share this video if you find it is useful to anyone. Thank you. So today we talk about shall we wait and buy later? Because many have told me that with this pandemic, the coming months will be even worse. Many people will lose their jobs. And recently, RWS has just laid off 2,000 of their employees. Everybody is worried about losing their job with all these uncertainties ahead. No doubt about that. If I'm in the same position, I will definitely have the same worry as well. But this pandemic that hit us, it wasn't new. If you recall what had happened to SIA in March, it was something that was never happened before since our independence. Aviation and tourism industry was the most hardest hit, and it is still ongoing. But the thing is what? Did you feel the impact in March? Or did you see an impact in our property market? So whatever your answer is, I would like to say, we really need to thank our government that had done so much with the relief and the support scheme that helped our Singaporeans. But for now, for those who are planning to buy a property, are you buying your property to stay? Should I buy now? Or should I wait for the price to drop and buy later? But first of all, let's understand what is the mechanism that needed in order to cause the property price to drop. I did a similar video about why the resale price didn't drop much that explains some details. I put the link here and you can take a look later. But for now, to understand for the property price to go down further, what must happen? A transaction must happen. A sales must happen. What do I mean by that? Which means if there are many sellers who are willingly to sell way below their market value, there must be sufficient home buyers who buy this property. If not, there won't be any sales or any transaction. In short, there must be a large supply of fire sales property. At the same time, the same amount of demand who transact this property so that we can see a significant price drop. But if there is no fire sales going on, or the people are not buying the properties at this moment, then how can we able to see the price to drop if everybody is waiting and there isn't sufficient numbers of transactions to affect the price index? So besides that, we witnessed a surge in June sales, and that was mainly due to the after circuit breaker effect. But what caught our surprise was more sales was done for the new homes, which usually the price is higher. And one of the reasons why more home buyers had chosen new homes instead could have explained in my previous video as well, and I'll put up the link here. But another main reason is also because of this crisis, which most developers continue to remain their price sensitively. They dare not increase their price too much, even though the construction cost has increased and the land supply had also cut recently. And that is why some projects are also giving some discounts so that they can continue to sell their units, and therefore it could be an opportunity for home buyers to buy a new home instead. But I have a customer thought that people who buy new launch are for investment, not for homestay, which I agree with her on certain points. But not exactly all the new homes are bought by investors, because if we look closely into the article, not just a headline, we can find out that majority of the home buyers are actually Singaporeans. They are either first-time buyers or HDB upgraders, because most people are still buying their property as a home to stay, not exactly for investment. So should you buy now or buy later? Ultimately, it's really boils down to our own timeline, because we are actually racing on our own time. We can only grow older each day, and nobody could possibly time the market exactly. So as long as you did your homework and research well, and also understanding the risk and the entry price, you can make your own decision by then. So this will come to the end of my video, and I hope this video will be helpful to you with a better understanding about properties. So if you like this video, please give a thumbs up, share, or subscribe to my channel. And please comment below if you'd like to find out more on property issue. I will do my best to answer them in the next video. And I will see you. As always, stay safe and take care.